Version 18 of Node.js was released to the public on April 19th. This comes with many new features that benefit front-end and back-end. Version 18 added an experimental test runner module to support basic native testing without the need of any runners like Jest. Fetch, a highly desirable API, has been added globally as a default, but is currently experimental pending more test coverage. Two more APIs have graduated from their experimental status, Blob and Broadcast Channel, and are now available globally. Also, the V8 engine has been updated to version 10.1 to take advantage of the latest JavaScript features. With this new release, it was also announced that Node version 12 is in end of life this month, so it's recommended to upgrade to a later version. If you're not sure which one to upgrade to, most even versions of Node are long-term supported, while most odd are experimental, so version 14, 16, or even 18 would be recommended. This is not all the new version entails, so check out the release notes linked in the description below for more details on the latest features from Node.js version 18.
The Q2 release of SAP Analytics Cloud is coming next month with over 40 new features. In her blog post, Orla Cullen gave links to all the details, as well as a sneak peek into her top 5. Including analytic applications support on Android devices and custom widget data binding capability in Analytics Designer. The Analytics Designer is very popular among those developing on SAP Analytics Cloud these days. There were several noteworthy examples shared by the community recently. Hui Min shared her learnings building an analytics application for a KPI dashboard to create a gamified leaderboard. She shares what widgets she used and sample code to make them work together. Something completely different has been shared by James Barlow, Pac-Man Analytics Application, or SACMAN, as he called it. He did an exercise of building an analytics app that brought together a number of scripting elements, primarily as an exercise in understanding script interactions and chains of events. If you are a beginner, then check the Scripting for Beginners series published by Svenja Winkler. In the latest part, she describes how results from charts can be reused in an application, for example, by creating awards. Talking about tips shared by the community and moving to SAP HANA now. This week, Matthias Kemeter published a step-by-step guide describing the bare minimum to get HDB CLI and dependent clients like the Python machine learning client for SAP HANA working on a computer with Apple M1 chip. As always, links to all these publications are in the description of this video.
Hi everyone. Older versions of SAP UI5 will gradually be removed from the CDN. We have had this announcement in the SAP developer news before, but now it's getting really serious. Starting mid-May, each week the three lowest SAP UI5 versions and patches that have reached their end of cloud provisioning will be removed. This is your call to action to ensure your apps run on an up-to-date SAP UI5 version or patch. The team recommends to use a long-term maintenance version equal to or greater than 1.71. Check the link in the description below to get more information. Also check out the new patch-level independent bootstrap feature that was announced recently, so you can always benefit from the latest patches without having to touch your code.